Dear President, dear Madam Commissioner, dear colleagues, first I would like to thank the Shadow Rapporteurs, European Women's Lobby, Victim Support Europe and European Added Value Assessment for the contribution to the report. Violence against women is a severe violation of human rights and a form of gender-based discrimination. It is the root cause of gender inequality, as it is an obstacle to women's full participation in economic, social, political and cultural life. According to the study's European Added Value Assessment, around 20 to 25% of women in Europe have experienced acts of physical violence at least once during their adult lives, and over 10% have suffered sexual violence involving the use of force. As many as 45% of women have endured some form of violence. 12 to 15% of women in Europe are victims of domestic violence, and 7 women die every day in the Union from it. The economic cost of violence against women in the EU in 2011 is estimated to €228 billion each year, including €45 billion for services, €24 billion in lost economic output, and €159 billion on pain and suffering. The cost of preventive measures are substantially less than the cost of violence. There have been a number of calls by Parliament to the Commission to come forward with a new wide strategy, including legislation to combat violence against women. Today in the EU there is neither a legislative act establishing measures to promote and support the action of Member States, nor a comprehensive strategy to combat violence against women. The outcomes and levels of protection of women and girls within the 28 EU Member States differ widely. There is no doubt that violence against women has a cross-border dimension and needs to be tackled at EU level. There is a need for minimum standards, common definition and action. The report contains a resolution that sets the sense for a legislative annex. The annex proposes a regulation based on Article 84 of the Treaty that foresees the exchange of best practices, information and training of officials involved. The report proposing using the passerelle clause set out in Article 83(1) of the Treaty to add gender-based violence to the list of so-called Eurocrimes with a cross-border dimension. Legislative INI also requests the Commission to submit by the end of 2014 a proposal for an act establishing measures to promote and support the action of Member States in the field of prevention of violence against women. It also insists on the need of a coherent system for collecting statistics on gender-based violence, request the Commission to propose a new action plan on FGM addressing several issues like prevention and protection. The annex urges the Member States, not having done so yet, to ratify the Istanbul Convention on Violence Against Women and urges the Commission to launch the procedure for the accession of the EU to the same instrument, and also proposes the Commission to adopt the first steps towards establishing a European Observatory on Violence Against Women, building on existing institutional structures such as the European Institute for Gender Equality. It also requests the Commission to establish in the next 3 years an EU year to end violence against women with the aim of raising awareness among citizens. The EU should therefore become the leading international actor in preventing gender-based violence, and we should ensure that a life free from violence becomes a reality for all women in the EU. I hope that we will have the great opportunity tomorrow with a majority to support this legislative INI and to call on the Commission for very, very, very strong commitment towards this report. Thank you very much.